Today, we're going to create realistic lipstick, all with the power of Affinity Photo. If you'd like to follow along with me, I've left a download link in the video description for the photo I'll be using. To make lipstick, the first thing we need to do is make a new fill layer. To do this, come to the top to Layer, and then select New Fill Layer. Then, change the fill layer to a nice deep shade of red. You can choose a different color if you want, but I like the way red lipstick looks, so that's what we'll use in this video. After choosing a color, we need to change the fill layer's blend mode from Normal to Multiply. What we need to do next is make it so this red is only being shown on the woman's lips. To do this, we'll use a layer mask. We can apply a white layer mask by clicking on the mask icon, but a little tip for you is that you can hold down Alt or Option, and then if you click on the mask icon, you'll create a mask that's already filled in with black. If you want to learn more about layer masks, you can check out our beginner's guide to Affinity Photo in the video description, where we cover them in much greater depth. Now all we need to do is paint white on the mask to reveal red on the woman's lips. So press B to get out the paintbrush tool, and then make sure you're painting in white. Now select the mask layer and zoom in a little bit to work more accurately. In the context toolbar, make sure you're painting with 0% hardness, 100% flow, and 100% opacity. Then make your brush nice and small. I'll make mine just 15 pixels. With this small brush, we're going to trace the outer edge of where we want the lipstick to go. If you remember back to coloring things as a kid, we were taught to color the edges first and then fill in the center. That's exactly what we're going to do here. First, we'll paint the edges of our lipstick and then fill in the center. At this stage, it's really important to take your time as you trace the edges of where the lipstick will go. If the outer edge of the lipstick looks sloppy, then your final result will not look very good. Sometimes, though, it might be a little tricky to know where to draw the lipstick because the lip and skin color are so similar. In that case, just draw the lipstick wherever you think looks good. This is the time to unleash your inner painting skills. You don't need to trace the lips exactly, you just need to trace where you think lipstick would look good. After painting the edges, I like to keep my brush the same small size and then paint around the edge again. This way, I have a nice thick border to work with, which allows me to use a bigger brush to fill in the center of the lips. With our second layer of edge painting done, we can increase the size of our brush and start filling in the center. You can quickly change your brush size by using the left and right bracket keys on your keyboard. Using these keyboard shortcuts is great because you can quickly make your brush smaller to fill in trickier areas, but then make it bigger to fill in the center of the lips. When you think you've filled the lips all the way, you can double-check your work by holding down Alt or Option and clicking on the mask's layer icon. This lets you see exactly where you've painted on your mask. If you see any areas you've missed, you can fill them in now. After filling in the missing spots on your mask, just click on any layer other than the mask layer to turn your view back to normal. At this point, our lipstick is looking kind of good, but not too realistic. Fortunately, there's still more that we can do to polish our work. The first thing we're going to do is soften the edges of our lipstick. Right now, the edges are way too crisp to be realistic. To soften the edges, we're going to apply a Gaussian blur filter to the mask, which will blur its edges. To apply a blur filter, we first need to select the mask layer and then come to our filters. Now we can apply a Gaussian blur filter. Unfortunately, this didn't apply the blur filter to our mask. Instead, it placed the blur filter at the top of our layers, where it will blur everything in our photo. That's not what we want. Most of the time, we could just drag this filter layer down and to the right of another layer, and then it would become a child layer. But for some reason, Affinity won't let us apply a child layer to masks. I have no idea why this is, but I do know a way around it. First, drag the mask layer to the top of the Layers panel. Now, with the mask at the top, we can make our Gaussian blur filter a child layer by dragging it down and to the right of the mask. For some reason, our mask now accepts the blur filter as a child layer. Then, we just need to drag the mask down and to the right of the fill layer. Now our mask is applied to the fill layer, and our blur filter is applied to the mask. With those shenanigans out of the way, we can finally use the blur filter to soften the edges of our lipstick. Just double-click on the blur layers icon, and then you can bring the blur radius up to whatever you think looks good. I'll set mine to 2.5 pixels. As you can see, the blur filter really helps to make our lipstick look more natural. The next thing we're going to do is make it so our dark red lipstick is only applied to the dark parts of her lips. Later, we'll make a lighter shade to apply to the highlights of her lips. This will look much more realistic than having all her lips be the same color. First, select the fill layer and then press on the gear icon. This brings up our blend ranges. Blend ranges are extremely powerful, but can be a little tricky to understand. We'll keep it simple in this video, but if you want to learn more about blend ranges, you can watch our complete beginner's guide to Affinity Photo in the video description. For now though, to make our lipstick only apply to the dark parts of her lips, we'll bring the circle on the far right down. The farther we bring it down, the less our red fill layer will be applied to the highlights. I'll bring mine 3/4 of the way down. Already, we can see what a dramatic improvement this has on our lipstick. Next, we'll make the lipstick for her lips highlights. We'll need to exit out of blend ranges, and then we'll duplicate our fill layer by pressing Command or Control J. By duplicating our fill layer, we don't need to go through the process of painting on our mask again, or applying another Gaussian blur filter. But with our duplicate fill layer, we're going to make a couple of tweaks. First, let's change its blend mode from Multiply to Screen. Then we'll press V for the Move tool. Having the Move tool out allows us to change the fill layer's color. Let's change it from dark red to a light orange. Now, we need to change its blend ranges, since right now this fill layer is only being applied to the dark parts of her lips, just like the layer it was duplicated from. Let's press on the gear icon to open our blend ranges again. Now we'll bring the far right circle all the way back up, and then this time we'll bring the third circle down. This makes it so our light orange color is not applied to the dark parts of her lips. And if bringing the circle all the way down isn't strong enough for you, you can bring the circle to the right as well. By bringing the circle down and to the right, our lipstick's highlight color is only being applied to the brightest parts of her lips. Now if we exit blend ranges, we can see that this highlight layer is really helping to make our lipstick look more realistic. At this point, you can continue tweaking the colors and blend ranges for each one of the fill layers until you have the exact colors you want. Now our lipstick is looking really good, and we're just about done. But I have a few more tips for you to make the lipstick look even better. The first tip is that you can add more shine to the lips by using a black rectangle that's been set to color dodge. Ezra already made a video on how to do this, so I won't cover this technique in detail here. If you want to learn how to add shine though, I'll leave a link to the tutorial he made in the video description. The next tip is to group all of the layers you use to make the lipstick. To do this, just select the layers, and then press Command or Control G. With all of our lipstick layers inside of a group, we can lower the opacity of the group if we don't want our lipstick to be as intense. Or, if we want the lipstick to be even more noticeable, we can duplicate the entire group by pressing Command or Control J. And of course, we can always lower the opacity of the duplicate group. And when you're totally satisfied with your lipstick's coloring and lighting, I have one more tip for you. First, right-click on any of the layers, and then press Merge Visible. Then drag the merged layer to the top of the Layers panel. With our merged layer selected, we can come to the top to the Liquify persona. Inside the Liquify persona, we can move our photo's pixels around like paint on a canvas. However, if we hadn't merged our layers into one, then when we liquify the woman's lips, the lipstick would not move with it. That's why we had to combine everything into a single layer so it would all move together. Inside the Liquify persona, I like to uncheck Show Mesh and lower the hardness of my brush. Then we can zoom in and make our brush smaller by using the bracket keys on our keyboard. Now we can move her lips and lipstick around. I think I'll make her smile a little bit. She's probably happier after getting a free makeover, right? I'll also make her bottom lip a little bigger and reshape some of the lipstick on the top lip. When you're done liquifying, press Apply at the top. To see a before and after, I'm first going to zoom out by pressing Command or Control 0. Then I'll bring our original photo layer right underneath our final layer. If we turn our final layer off, we can see the photo we started with. And if we turn the final layer back on, you can see the woman with her lipstick applied. Thanks for watching, my friends, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.